Hello, children. You're welcome to Unit 1.3. We are still on Lesson 1, and I hope you are having fun because I'm having fun on this Beginner Programming for Kids Course 1. So today we are going to learn something from the last class that we talked about. Remember, we mentioned some words, program and instruction, and we were like, what does this word mean? So today we'll learn it, and then we'll also learn something else. This is what I'm going to talk about today. Who is a programmer and what is a program? Remember, you are learning to become a programmer, somebody who can work with a computer. So, but who is a programmer and what is a program? Good. That is all we're going to talk about today. Okay, now let me hear from you. Who is a programmer? Okay. Don't worry. I'm going to teach you that today, okay? But I will need you to listen and to understand what I'm saying so that from today henceforth, you'll be able to tell me who a programmer is. Is that okay? Very good. Super. Good. Now, who is a programmer? A programmer, or which people also refer to as a coder. People call programmers coders. They say, oh, that person is a coder. That person can code. It's just the same thing. A programmer or a coder is a person that writes computer program or code. Simple. Don't allow any of those adults to start disturbing you and telling you big grammar. There's no big grammar. A programmer is a person that writes computer program or code. Now, what programmers do is that they learn a programming language and use it to write these instructions for the computer. So anybody cannot just be a programmer, even if they can work with the computer. It's not everybody that can use the computer that are programmers. No, some people are just only using the computer with the program that other people have developed. But you that can develop, a person that can develop a computer, a program for the computer, that is, can tell the computer, do this, and the computer will do it, do that, and the computer will do it, is called a programmer. Is that okay? Good. So let's re-emphasize again. A programmer or a coder is a person that writes computer program or codes. They are able to do this because they learn a programming language. What is a programming language, you will ask? What is a programming language? Don't worry. I will teach you what a programming language is. Is that okay? Good. So for now, just know that to become a programmer, you need to learn a programming language. And if you learn a programming language, you need to use it to write instructions for your computer. Good. So that is what you are learning to become. You are learning to become a programmer. And you are going to learn a programming language in this course. You are going to learn the Scratch programming language. And you are going to use that programming language that you learn to instruct the computer. You would use it to instruct the computer. You would design games. You would do animation. You use it to tell stories. It's going to be fun. Is that okay? Very good. So today we have learned who a programmer or a coder is. Now the next thing is, what is a program or a code? Good. What is a program or a code? Is that okay? Good. A program or a code is a list of step-by-step instructions that makes a computer do what you want it to do. So let me say, for example, you want the computer to add two numbers together and tell you the total of the number. Is that not so? Good. First, I will say, computer, number one is this. My first number is this. Computer, my second number is this. Computer, add my number one and my number two together and tell me the total of the both numbers. Is that okay? So that step-by-step instruction is what we refer to as a program or a code. Is that okay? Good. For example, I want to instruct my dog again, Jackie. I want Jackie to go out from the room. I will say, Jackie, leave the room, and then you see that Jackie will go. So that first, I called Jackie. Second, I told Jackie, leave the room. So those two things are step-by-step instructions. Very good. So you want the computer to be able to tell you when it's 7 a.m. So I'm going to say, when it's 7 a.m., Sound an alarm. That is a program that you can write. Is that okay? Very good. Now, there are different types of programming language, or which you can also call coding language. There's Java, there's Python, C++, Scratch, C#, JavaScript, and a lot of others. Is that okay? So how many programming languages have I mentioned? Java, Python, C++, Scratch, C#, JavaScript. I've mentioned six for you. So remember in unit 1.1, we said that one of the objectives is for you to be able to list other programming languages. So you must know these programming languages. Is that okay? Good. That's my good student. Now, in this course, you as a programmer, you are going to learn the Scratch programming language. Is that okay? So you are going to learn the Scratch programming language. Very good. So today we have learned who a programmer is, or who people also call a coder. We have also learned what a program is or what a code is. And in our next class, we are going to learn what? Yes, I'm going to introduce you to a very great question that will be bothering you right now. Right now, you may be thinking, programmers are people that write instructions for computer to follow. Something will be going through your mind. So in the next class, I'm going to introduce you to that great question that is going through your mind. So sit tight, and also don't forget to do my assignment. My assignment is I want you to recite over and over again who a programmer is, what is a program, and the different types of what? Of the programming languages that you know. And in the next unit, I'm going to see you and I'm going to introduce you to that great question which is running through your mind, and we'll answer it together. So see you in the next lesson. And also remember that, yeah, I admire you for wanting to learn to become a programmer. See you in the next lesson and have fun. Enjoy yourself. Is that okay? Very good, very good.